बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। इन द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह द मोस्ट ग्रेशियस द मोस्ट मर्सीफुल। आई एम जी तारिक हियर फ्रॉम कंप्यूटर साइंस डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डिवीजन पब्लिक स्कूल एंड इंटर कॉलेज लाहौर। टुडे वी आर हियर फॉर लेक्चर नंबर 9th ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस क्लास 10th। We are doing unit number 2, data types, assignment and input output statements. In the previous lecture we have learned how to write programs in GW Basic, how to create, save, load and execute basic programs. Today we are going to do structure of basic program and character set of basic, and these topics are given on page number 15, 16 and 17 of your textbook. For the structure of basic program, we have to follow some rules. The first one is every program line must begin with a line number. You have already know the range. It's from 0 to 65,529. But there is a convention that we use 10, 20, 30 and so on for making our programs. It's up to you that you can use this convention or you can use any from this given range. The second rule is, it is a good practice to end every program with an end statement. However, it is not mandatory. Mandatory means compulsory. In this program, I have assigned three values, 98, 65 and 20 to x, y and z respectively. And I have written a short formula, x plus y minus z, means that 98 will be added to 65 and 20 will be subtracted from it. And you can see in line number 50, I have written an end statement. In the second picture or the second program, it's the same but without an end statement. When I will execute these both, you can see the output is the same without any error. Third rule is, repetition of line numbers is not allowed. It should be on your fingertips now. You have remembered this program? I have written a program with only two lines and the line numbers are same. And in the output, you can see the second line has replaced the first one because of the same line number. The fourth rule is also repeated many times. Two or more lines can be written on a single line, but they must be separated by a colon. For example, in this example, print Pakistan and print DPS are two separate statements, but these are written on the same line number 10 with a colon sign in between these. And in line number 20, we have three different statements on a single line separated by colon. Rule number 5 is, in basic, variables can be used without declaration. For the time being here, variable means a memory place and declaration means definition. In some cases, without defining or mentioning the type of memory place with its name, we can store values. For example, here in line number 10, I have stored 99 in a place A without mentioning its type. But in line number 20, I have declared B as an integral type place where we can store only integers, not any value with fractional part in it. When I execute this program, no error occurs and it gives me both the values in the answer. The next rule is also on your fingertips. In a basic program, the physical appearance of the program statements does not matter. For example, in a program, line number 90 can appear before line number 60. However, the program statements will always execute according to the ascending order of specified line numbers. You remember this example, 40, 50, 60, 45. Line numbers are not given in order in the program. But when we will execute these are executed in ascending order. Next is the character set of basic program. Character set of a language defines all characters which are valid to be used in the programs written in that language. The character set of GW Basic comprises of alphabets, numeric and some special characters. The alphabets include upper and lower case letters, the capital ABC and small ABC, A to Z. Numeric characters include digits from 0 to 9. The special characters of GW Basic character set are: the first one is blank. When you press spacebar, it creates the blank. The next is equal sign, or you can use it as an assignment symbol. For example, if I write a is equals to 5, it means that I am going to assign the value 5 to the variable a. The plus sign is used for addition purpose or for string concatenation. For example, I have written two strings, computer and lab. And when I write plus in between these two, it will combine both the strings. Remember that string means a combination of alphabets. Minus sign is used for subtraction, asterisk or multiplication symbol, slash is used for division, it will return you quotient, caret is used for exponentiation or it behaves like a control key. For example, in mathematics we write 5 raised to the power 2 as written above, but in computer sciences we write 5 caret 2 to represent 5 raised to the power 2. Left and right parentheses are very familiar to you, these are the types of brackets. There are some more special characters: percent or integer declaration, number sign or double precision declaration, dollar sign or string declaration, exclamation symbol or single precision declaration. The first four characters will be discussed later in the upcoming lectures as type declaration characters. Left bracket and right bracket, you are familiar with these type of brackets. Then we can use comma and the double quotes or double quotation marks. It is also known as string delimiter. For example, when we write 10 print computer, you know computer is a string and we have to write it in the double quotes. The next character is period, dot or decimal point. You can also use it in your programs. The list is not completed yet. There are some more special characters: single quotation, apostrophe or remark symbol. Remember that we have used this symbol, a dotted line and a left bracket, when we were drawing the flowcharts. Here we use the single quotation marks to give additional descriptive text in our program. Next is the semicolon or carriage return suppressor. Carriage return is the enter key. If you want to avoid using the enter key, then you use this symbol to avoid your line goes to the next line. Colon or line statement delimiter. It tells you you can write two statements on a single line, but you have to use this colon sign in between these. Ampersand or descriptor for hexadecimal octal number conversion. You have learned the number conversions in class 9th. Hexa to octal, octal to hexa. All these are used by using the ampersand sign. The question mark, less than and greater than symbol are very much familiar. The backslash or integer division symbol, it will give you the result in the form of integer by omitting the fractional part. The last few special characters are underscore. You can use underscore in your programs. The backspace key, it is used to delete the last character type, or you can use it to erase the character at the left side of the cursor. ESC or escape key erases the current line from the screen. The tab key is used to give 8 spaces all at once. Remember that the spacebar key gives you only 1 space, but the tab key gives 8 spaces. The enter key is used both in direct and indirect mode. In the indirect mode, it terminates input to a line, means that it ends writing in a line and moves the cursor to the beginning of next line. Or in the direct mode, it is used to execute or run the statement or the command written in direct mode. Today we have learned structure of BASIC program and a long list of character set of BASIC, and I hope you have understood these. So here is the first assignment from Unit 2. You have to write the output of the following program. I want you to guess the output first and write on the paper, and then type and execute this program in PC BASIC, which I hope you have downloaded now. If you have not installed it yet, then get the link how to download and install PC BASIC from the description of this video. Link to this assignment is also provided there. I'll be waiting for your assignments on rigzy000@gmail.com. Till next lecture, take care and Allah Hafiz.